Professor Antelle scooped a little up in his hand and said, "It can't be anything but water." He gave an exclamation of surprise. There, beneath Betelgeuse, above our heads, like an enormous red balloon, was the print of a human foot. "It's a woman's foot," said Arthur Levain. I held my breath at the marvelous beauty of this creature from Soror, illuminated by the blood-red beams of Betelgeuse. I named her Nova in comparison to a brilliant star. We heard a noise in the forest, and our friend Hector came into view. As he passed, without noticing her, she sprang out. She seized him by the throat and closed her hands around his neck, while she held the poor creature firm between her thighs. Her attack was so swift, the monkey hardly struggled. He fell dead when she let go of him. The rest of the afternoon passed without incident. At dawn the next day, we heard her approach. She was not alone. A man was with her. It was her father. They led us to an area where there were many wild, primitive humans.